Kevin Shelley from University of Wisconsin Extension Nutrient and Pest Management Program. And I'm going to discuss the benefits of planting winter cereal rye as a cover crop following harvest of corn as silage. When we harvest corn as silage, we're removing the entire plant from the field. So we leave very little crop residue remaining to cover the soil surface. It's also a popular time to apply manure, and so we might be left with a situation vulnerable to both soil erosion and nutrient runoff. The winter rye germinated and emerged, providing an overwintering vegetative cover to help protect the soil. This spring, it started to grow again, and in portions of the field, we sprayed it with a burn down herbicide to prepare the field for planting this year's corn crop. So this treatment is winter cereal rye as a cover crop only. In other portions of the field, we left the rye grow to provide an early season forage crop. In research trials and on-farm demonstrations, we've been able to average about 2 tons of dry matter of forage yield per acre. Relative forage quality ranges between 140 and over 200. To optimize yield and forage quality, it's very important that the rye is harvested in the boot stage or as close to it as possible. The boot stage is that stage of growth just prior to the seed head emerging from the top of the stem. If we cut the rye for harvest after the point at which the seed head has emerged from the stem, protein and digestible fiber levels decrease rapidly. The optimum window is very narrow, so once that boot stage is close, if the weather allows, we need to cut. For more information, there is a publication available on the Nutrient and Pest Management Program's website entitled Planting Winter Rye After Corn Silage, Managing for Forage. You can also contact your local county extension agent.